In this illustration, we'll discuss about winding of a string on a cylinder. Here, we are given that a vertical cylinder of radius r is placed on a horizontal surface and a small disc m is attached to the cylinder by a horizontal thread mb of length l0, one end of which is attached to the cylinder at point b as shown, and a disc is thrown with the initial velocity v0 so that thread starts winding over the surface of cylinder, and we are going to find the time after which a disc will strike the cylinder. Here you can see as the disc is thrown with the horizontal velocity v0, it starts moving in horizontal plane and finally it will wind on the cylinder. Here I can draw the picture to understand. If this is the initial position of disc and say after time t, it reaches over here. Here we can see as tension in a string is acting normal to its velocity, the velocity v0, the magnitude of velocity v0 will not change. It will continue to move at a uniform speed v0. And say if from t equals to 0 to t, it has rotated by an angle theta, then this string will also have turned by an angle theta, and the length of a string over here will be L0 minus r theta. And in a further time dt, say if I rotate by an angle d theta on cylinder also, it will wind by an angle d theta. So in this situation here we can write along the trajectory of this, displacement of disc in time dt is, this displacement we can simply write as v0 dt. If this time is t and here it is at time t plus dt, then it has traveled a distance v0 dt, and this distance can be written as this length of a string is L0 minus r theta, then this can be written as L0 minus r theta multiplied by d theta. Now this expression can be integrated. V0 dt is L0 minus r theta d theta. From t equals to 0 when theta was 0, and at a general time t, theta changes to the whole angle to which the string will revolve on the cylindrical surface, that will be L0 by r. So on left hand side it will be V0 t, and on right hand side on integrating this, L0 theta minus r theta square by 2, and we substitute the limits from 0 to L0 by r, which will give us L0 square by r minus L0 square by 2r, which is L0 square by 2r. So here the time after which this disc will strike the cylindrical surface, or the string will completely wind on the cylindrical surface, is given as L0 square by 2r V0. That will be the final result of this problem.